Hey guys, it's Vignesh from CodeAndroid. In this video, we'll see about widgets in Flutter. In Flutter, all the components used for defining UI elements are called widgets, like how view in Android and UI view in iOS. It might be button, text, padding or margin, everything is considered as widgets. There are two types of widget available in Flutter, stateful widget and stateless widget. First, we'll see about stateful widget. As the name suggests, the UI will be linked to a state, so that by modifying the state, we can update the UI at runtime. If we have a validation and if it fails, then we can show error message by showing a UI component. In this case, we need to modify the state of an UI widget which causes UI to re-render. In this example, we have a terms and condition page where user need to accept terms and condition before using the application. If the user try to click on continue button without accepting the terms, then we are showing an error message. Like this, if we need to do any UI change at runtime, then we need to use stateful widget. Now we'll see about stateless widget. Stateless widgets are rendered only once, so we can't update the part of the UI without recreating entire UI. This will be helpful to avoid re-rendering the UI again and again if other part of the UI gets updated. Now we took the same example, but we removed the checkbox and update the button text as accept and continue. By doing this, we are removing the validation required for the checkbox. As we remove the validation, there is no need to update the UI at runtime. So, according to our UI need, we can choose the widget type. To check all the pre-built components, we can visit flutter.dev. I will give this link in the description, so you can check it out. Here, we have material components for Android and Cupertino components for iOS. According to the UI we need, either we can choose material widgets or Cupertino widgets. Also, we can have conditions in UI so that Android can use material widgets and iOS can use Cupertino widgets. To get the source code of these components, we have Flutter Gallery, where we can find source code for all of the components. Also, we can see how each of the components will look without adding the code in our project. Now, we have seen the theory of widget. In next video, we'll see about this in code. That's all for this video, guys. If you have any doubts, please put it in the comment section. I will try to answer it. Hope you like it. I will see you in my next video. Have a nice day.